Hello, this is just a quick video to show you how to create a drop shadow in Procreate, and it really couldn't be simpler. So open up Procreate and I'm into a drawing I've done previously, and you can see with this chap there's no drop shadow behind him. Assuming I want to add a drop shadow, if I go onto the layers palette and then go up to the top of him, which is going to be his hat, if I select that and then just swipe right on each of the other elements that are within the character, all the way down, the neck being the last one there, then in the top right of that panel you'll see it says group. If I click on group, I've now grouped all of those together, and you'll see here it says new group, which I could rename if I want to man. I can now collapse that group, and now if I swipe to the left I get the opportunity to duplicate it. I'm going to duplicate it, and then on that top layer I'm actually going to say flatten, and it then flattens the image into just one simple image. I can now turn off the one of the group for the man, and I've just got this flattened image, layer 10 as it is here. If I swipe right on that, I can duplicate. I've now got two of them. If I turn off the top one, I'm left just with this alpha locked bottom one. So now, if I change the color here to black, go to my brushes, and I'll go to airbrushing, hard brush at the bottom there, and choose that. If I now, with my brush size all the way up, paint over that, I've created my outline in black. Now the thing to do is to turn off the alpha lock so that I'm not locked onto that, because I want to add a Gaussian blur, and you can't do that if it's alpha locked. So if I just add a Gaussian blur, maybe to about 19% there, so it's like that, I can then turn on my top flattened layer, but still with my black layer selected. If I click on the selection tool, I can now move that to offset it on my image. Now in this case, of course, what I've ended up doing is dropping that drop shadow below my background, which I really don't want. So what I can do now, layer one you can see is that background. If I select that, and then if I just click out and say select, it's now selected just that object. Now I can go on to invert, and I've now got the inverted selection of that object. I can now, with that still on, click onto layer 10, the black image, and use the eraser, this time with the hard airbrush turned all the way up, and just come round and cut out the bottom of that image. And I could do it at the top as well if I want, but I'm going to just do it at the bottom for this. Just make sure you're not cutting out anything too high up, which I was there. Okay, and then when I come off that selection, you'll see I've got a drop shadow which doesn't bleed over at the bottom, and the image is complete. So that is how you create a drop shadow in Procreate.